आई एम लेफ्टिनेंट डॉक्टर प्रशांत आंबेकर फ्रॉम धर्मपेठ एम पी देव मेमोरियल साइंस कॉलेज नागपुर. आई एम फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजिक्स एंड विल बी डीलिंग अ पार्ट ऑफ योर पेपर 1 यूनिट 3 एंड यूनिट 4 वेर इन आई विल कवर सरफेस टेंशन एंड न्यूटोनियन मैकेनिक्स. आई एम श्योर यू नो दिस टॉपिक, एटलीस्ट यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट इट, isn't it? Yes, surely you know various surfaces like solid surfaces in which you might have touched smooth or hard surfaces or different shapes and size. You have also seen or touched the liquid surfaces as well. Moreover, the second word is never away from you, as most of you keep it in mind. Attention, don't you? Let us begin with the surface tension topic. At the outset, I must let you know the coverage of this video presentation. We shall see the introduction to surface tension with few naturally available examples, definitions involved in its explanation such as cohesion, adhesion, angle of contact, etc. Moreover, we shall study the method to determine the surface tension of liquid. Here we will see the capillary rise method. Let us see some natural examples. In these photographs, here you see a pointed thorn with attached droplets to it. Few droplets are at lower side and one droplet is shown attached to its upper side. Why these lower droplets are not falling down? Is there any effect of gravity on them or not? Or the gravity effect is cancelled by some other forces? Similarly, here a bubble is just emerging out from the orifice of this tube and it is going down, but momentarily it is staying there. Why the shape of this bubble is like this, elongated spear or something? In this picture, an insect with six legs is floating on the surface of water. The similar case is also observed here. A droplet of water is floating on the surface of water over which an ant is standing over there or playing with it maybe. What is the reason behind this? In another picture, you see an U-pin which is made up of steel having density around 8 grams per cubic centimeter, which is 8 times more than water, is floating on the surface of water. Can it be possible? Yes, you can do it at your home. So there are many questions arising here. Maybe you might have more questions even. So let us discuss it. You can discuss it among yourself, your friends, or with me too. Many questions arises here. Why the soap bubble have spherical shape? Why free falling water drop or a smaller droplet have spherical shape? Why the shape of water drop placed on a suitable surface, a depressed one, as you can see here, they are depressed spheres. Why liquid rises in a narrow capillary tube? What is the reason behind the oil lamp working by auto-fueling mechanism, which may be based on either kerosene or diesel? Can we find a reason that watering the plants or trees till its apex? Why few insects can float on water surface? So these many even more questions can come in your mind, and now we have to answer them, or we have to search their answers. Now again, you may have learned that these phenomena were already existing in nature and our forefathers used them in daily practice. But the phenomena, as the name surface tension, was not used by them, neither found any physical explanation or derived any relation for its determination. If I would say that the invention of surface tension originated from kitchen, shall it be a right statement? Yes, it is. Indeed, during the washing of dishes, Agnes Pockels came up with an idea of surface tension, and later in 1891 she published it in a Nature journal. Before going to the definition of surface tension directly, we must see some definitions which are needed to define the surface tension. So first definition comes, the surface. What do you mean by surface? The outermost part of or uppermost layer of something, that is water surface, mercury surface, or some solid material surface. Or in physics or in mathematics, the surface can be defined as the extended two-dimensional outer boundary of a three-dimensional object. That is nothing but the surface. Similarly, the tension, as I have already mentioned, the tension in your mind, but that is a bit a different kind of tension. It is due to some brain processes, and we are not looking to that particular tension, but here we are dealing with a tension resulting out of physical forces. Now, the strain state or a condition resulting from forces acting in opposite to each other is nothing but the tension. So, for example, if you have a rubber band, if you stretch it, you will see its elongation. At the same time, your fingers will experience certain oppositely directed forces. So, if I release it, it will go to its original shape and size. So, this is all due to the elastic forces, but this particular stretched straight of a rubber band, it is having under strained state, and that particular forces are nothing but the tension. It may be either a single force or a collection or group of forces, a couple of forces you can say. Now there is another question, why these liquid molecules are bound together? What is the forces responsible to have this kind of effect? So if you look at this water droplet which is on the surface of some solid material, the material may be anything, plastic, glassy, or some woody surface. So depending on its material, this water droplet have different kind of shapes. But if you look into the water droplet, if I magnify one of the portions inside the water droplet, it will be appearing like this. And this kind of particles or molecules of water are bound together due to some forces. These forces are called as cohesive forces. What are these cohesive forces? These are nothing but the intermolecular attractive forces. So if there is attraction between or among the molecules, as this arrow or this diagram shows, that the arrows are showing the pressure or the forces exerting on neighboring molecules. These are extended to every molecule. So therefore they are interacting with each other, and as a result of that the attractive forces will bound them together. But if you look at the surface, I have taken this magnified view of a surface, and here if you see there is no force acting out of the surface here on the surface of that or the particle of the liquid. So all the forces, these two forces are cancelling each other, and therefore these surface molecules are trying to go inside because of attraction due to other molecules. As a result of that, this may go inside and its position may be occupied by some other forces, its position will be occupied by other neighboring molecule. As a result of that, this membrane or rather the surface will experience an attractive force always, and therefore it will make a boundary to this liquid surface, and that bound all these molecules together due to cohesion. This phenomena is nothing but the cohesion occurring due to cohesive forces. Now exactly opposite to this is adhesion. So adhesion is again an attractive force but having a different molecule. Here the molecules were of similar kind or same kind rather, water molecules, but when you look at the adhesion phenomena, the substances are different and their molecules when got attracted to each other, the phenomena is called as adhesion. For example, you might have seen a few adhesives like quick fix or something, or some araldite or some amsyl, etc. These are the adhesives. These particular materials have adhesive forces more prominent as compared to cohesive forces, and therefore the phenomena is termed to be adhesive or adhesion. Now the another definition is nothing but the angle of contact. A capillary tube is inserted into water. Half of the portion is seen over here, and you see this is flattened surface here in the middle of the tube, but at the edge or where it is contacted to the glass material or wall, glass wall, it is lifted above. That means there must be some attractive forces working more prominent as compared to the attractive forces inside the water. So this is the example of adhesive forces. So water and glass has adhesive forces more stronger, and that's why the liquid is lifted inside the capillary tube. Now the definition of the angle of contact is given as when the liquid is in contact with the solid surface, the angle between the solid surface and the tangent to the free surface. Here this is the tangent made with the free surface of water, and the angle between the solid surface and the tangent to the free surface of water is nothing but the angle of contact, which is measured from inside the liquid. That means from this side to this, not from this to this. Again, in the similar experiment with mercury, the mercury meniscus is above as compared to, or at the outer side rather. Here the meniscus is this flattened surface, and here this is the meniscus of the mercury. It means that there, when it is contacted with glass, the mercury and glass has less adhesion as compared to cohesive forces or cohesion inside the mercury, and therefore the level will drop down, and therefore the angle of contact is obtuse angle of angle. Here in the water case it was acute, whereas in case of mercury and glass surface it is obtuse. Define the surface tension. The tension of the surface film of a liquid caused by attraction of the particles in the surface layer by the bulk of the liquid, which tend to minimize the surface area. Or in other words, surface tension is the tendency of a liquid surface to shrink into minimum surface area possible. Here also you will see they are attracting into the liquid, and therefore it will have this kind of surface always trying to go inside. Therefore the shape of the water droplet appears to be spherical, but it is contacted here with the solid portion and gravity is acting on it. That's why it is a flattened sphere. I hope you have learned the definition of surface tension. On that definition, I have a small exercise for you. In this exercise, I have taken three different shapes: a sphere having diameter 1 cm, a cube having side length 1 cm, and a circle having diameter 1 cm. So in this case, either this length of cube or the diameters of these two objects are same. Now calculate the volume and surface area of a cube having side length 1 cm, and compare it with the surface areas of sphere and the circle having same diameter. Now, what conclusions you draw out of these figures? Can we relate it with surface tension? Although we cannot calculate the volume of the circle being two-dimensional, do we have some more information of its surface area? Is it possible to have a cube of frozen liquid existing due to surface tension phenomena? And out of these shapes, which shapes would be best to float on water surface? Let us see now the capillary rise method to determine surface tension of any liquid. In this case, a capillary tube having radius R is inserted into a liquid. You can see here a liquid level rises up to this meniscus, where h is the height up to the meniscus of the increased level. Now being this capillary tube having very small diameter, the meniscus is appeared exactly like a hemispherical shape. Now, as we have earlier seen that the angle of contact is in this case shown by theta, and exactly opposite to this a surface tension vector is shown over here. So it means the liquid inside this capillary tube is pulled by this tension. So it has two components, as the upward or rather vertical component t cos theta, being this is theta, and the horizontal components t sin theta. These components are along the circumference of this tube. Now, as t sin theta are in all possible directions, they cancel out and you will get null effect over here. But all the t cos thetas are working along the circumference of this liquid, or rather the tube. Now, if we consider the volume of this increased level column or liquid column, it comes to be, let us consider it is capital V, that equals to volume of the liquid column of radius r of height h. That means it has a radius of r, as we know here, and it is having a height h. So by knowing the surface area over here and height h, I can have the volume knowledge, or knowledge of volume of this increased level or water column inside the capillary tube. Now it is added with this volume also. So what is that volume? Volume of liquid of radius r and height r. Here the liquid height is up to this, from this h. So this much is the height multiplied by the radius r. So this will give you the complete volume, but I have to subtract this volume from the entire volume of radius r. So what I will do, I will take the volume of a sphere, that is 4 by 3 pi r cube, and divide it by 2, so it will be 2 by 3 pi r cube. So I have taken this side, which is empty over here, and I have subtracted it from the actual volume of this column. Then I will get V equals to pi r square h plus 1 by 3 pi r cube. Now, as we know that I have calculated the volume, so the total upward force t cos theta will be added, but how much? Multiplied by twice pi r along the circumference, because inside that there is no liquid, only at the boundary of this tube there is a liquid and it is acting over there. So therefore the total upward force will comes to be t cos theta multiplied by twice pi r. So twice pi r t cos theta. Theta is the angle of contact, r is the radius of the tube, and if I take the rho as a density of the liquid, then I can have, if you go into the detail of this relation, you see at the denominator there is cos theta, and the theta being very small, nearly equals to 0 degree, you can have the value of cos theta as 1, and therefore you can get the final relation for surface tension as RH rho g divided by 2. For practical purpose, you can have this relation and perform this experiment, which is available in your laboratory. There are few questions which are asked in this exercise. I hope you understood all these earlier concepts, and you will solve this exercise 2 as well as exercise 3. Thank you.